Now that we've traversed the landscape of classical voting-based consensus mechanisms, we now arrive in modern times. In 2008, the release of the Bitcoin white paper not only revolutionized the way we thought of financial transactions, but also the way we reached consensus. For the first time, consensus was enabled not just at a small scale within a single company, but at the globally accessible level. In the present day, we can observe two main classes of consensus mechanisms, one inspired by classical literature, which we call voting-based consensus mechanisms, and ones inspired by Satoshi Nakamoto's Bitcoin, which we call Nakamoto consensus mechanisms. The main difference between the two is based on how updates happen. Voting-based refers to consensus mechanisms requiring explicit votes from nodes on the next update. On the other hand, Nakamoto consensus mechanisms diverge fundamentally from this idea, instead requiring users to vote implicitly. This is done with a random lottery based on consumed resources. Users expend some resource for the chance to make an update to the system. This is what happens in Bitcoin. Miners are randomly selected based on their hash power derived from energy to propose the next block. While the origins of Nakamoto consensus are in Bitcoin's proof-of-work mechanism, it isn't the only style of Nakamoto consensus. That's what we're going to be covering today in the section.